The Truxel Bridge concept and feasibility study will advance the city's plan to extend Truxel Road with a new bridge over the Lower American River into downtown. The study will develop a preferred layout for all of the different travelers on the bridge, including pedestrians, bicyclists, motorists, and transit riders. The study will also identify the physical constraints and design requirements of the various local, regional, state, and federal partners in order to identify a feasible horizontal and vertical alignment. This effort follows an alternatives analysis adopted by City Council in 2013 that established the need and purpose for crossing the Lower American River. That analysis identified the primary reasons for new or improved crossings, including the need to address activities that are limited due to existing conditions, future congestion, emergency response times, and natural disaster evacuation routes. That analysis also recognized the consequences of longer trips that relied on using state highways, including more trips by car, leading to more fuel consumption and producing more air pollution. There are four existing routes to cross the Lower American River. The Jaboom Street Bridge, located near the confluence with the Sacramento River, connects the Two Rivers Bike Trail with the Jedediah Smith Memorial Trail in Discovery Park and provides a two-lane crossing with sidewalks. Access to the Jaboom Street Bridge and Discovery Park is often frustrated by seasonal flooding. I-5 provides an all-weather, eight-lane bridge over the river with a posted speed limit of 65 miles per hour, no accommodations for pedestrians, and access for only the bravest of bicyclists when no other options are available. State Route 160 provides a six-lane bridge over the river with a narrow sidewalk on the westbound span with a connection to Northgate Boulevard that is also prone to seasonal flooding. Pipes Bridge is immediately east of State Route 160, offering a bicycle and pedestrian-only crossing for the Sacramento Northern Bikeway, but the connection beneath State Route 160 is also prone to seasonal flooding. City Council considered improvements to three of these crossings, as well as new crossings at five different locations in the 2013 analysis. City staff provided qualitative and quantitative analysis of these eight alternatives, and Council ultimately supported further analysis for the addition of pedestrian and bicycle facilities on I-5, a new all-modes bridge at Truxel Road, and all-weather improvements to Northgate Boulevard connecting to State Route 160. City staff identified the Truxel Bridge alternative as the most competitive project to receive a Caltrans Sustainable Transportation Planning Grant, which was awarded in 2022 for this concept and feasibility study. We are very early in the process of developing this bridge, and future phases will depend largely on the timing and availability of grant funding to advance the project. Your participation is appreciated and necessary to provide public context for City Council when they are asked to choose a preferred alternative moving forward.
The study has three primary components. The engineering component covers the technical aspects, including surveying, traffic, geotechnical, hydraulics, utilities, geometrics, and structures. Environmental considerations include biological and cultural resources, mitigation opportunities, and California Environmental Quality Act, National Environmental Policy Act, also known as Sequoia and NEPA requirements, and community outreach is being performed to inform and engage the public throughout the project. The final feasibility study will include an assessment of geometrics, flood control, environmental resources, structures, and funding. Let's look at the status of each of these assessments. So for the geometric assessment, the project is divided into three aspects. The first is the cross section, which defines the width of the bridge from one edge to the other. To date, the team has identified elements for serving multiple modes of travel and has coordinated with stakeholders to refine widths and placement of cross-sectional elements. Moving forward, we'll refine these elements, including the widths and locations of each element. Next is the horizontal alignment, or what the path the bridge will follow connecting Sequoia Pacific Boulevard to Truxel Road. To date, the team has identified existing infrastructure like buildings and utilities, identified existing environmental resources, and also developed alignments to reduce impacts. The team has identified the existing buildings and the infrastructure along Sequoia Pacific Boulevard, the PG&E power line towers along Garden Highway, and the trail connections as primary constraints. The final geometric assessment is the vertical alignment, or the height of the bridge above the ground. The team has completed survey to identify existing elevations of the site and also identified clearance requirements from Coast Guard, FEMA, and the American River Flood Control District. The PG&E power line towers along Garden Highway, the levees along the American River and Steelhead Creek, and the elevation of Garden Highway and Truxel Road are the primary constraints for the bridge height. The next step will be to evaluate the extent of walls needed along Garden Highway. The bridge is proposed to span the American River and Steelhead Creek, each of which carries significant flows during winter storms. As part of the flood control assessment to date, the team has coordinated with the Army Corps of Engineers and the Central Valley Flood Protection Board, and also obtained preliminary concurrence on vertical clearance from the U.S. Coast Guard. The constraints identified include navigable waterway clearance, levee freeboard requirements, and also allowable impacts to water surface elevations. The team will evaluate impacts from encroachments and also develop mitigation options for each of these impacts. The bridge will also span the environmentally rich expanse of the American River Parkway, so it will be important to assess the resources in the area, the potential impacts, and opportunities for mitigation. The team so far has completed an initial identification of biological and cultural resources, coordinated with Sacramento County Regional Parks, and also initiated outreach to Native American tribes. Constraints identified include the approximate location of cultural resources and the types of biological resources present, including protected species, sensitive habitat, and waters of the U.S. The next step in this assessment is to coordinate with the following resource agencies: California Department of Fish and Wildlife, United States Fish and Wildlife Service, National Marine Fisheries Service, and also Native American tribes. Ultimately, the centerpiece is the bridge. To help define the structural components of the bridge, the team has identified height and length requirements for the bridge, identified potential pier locations and widths, and identified potential structure types. The constraints identified include vertical clearance requirements from the Coast Guard, Army Corps of Engineers, and FEMA, and also environmental resource locations as it relates to pier placement. Our next steps are to optimize the pier locations with flood control and environmental resources, optimize bridge type with cost, and also assess foundation options and costs. The project cost and funding are also critical to the project's success. The team has conducted outreach to federal, state, and local representatives to raise awareness of the project and assess funding possibilities. The next step in this assessment is to identify the cost range anticipated for the project. The team is currently conducting community outreach in tandem with the preliminary investigations, which is anticipated to wrap up in the summer of 2024. These activities will be followed by the funding assessments into fall of 2024 and completion of the feasibility study in January of 2025.